Southwest Florida, welcome back. As I said before, hail to the chief. He is here. Let's bump you in. Chief of the Fire Department, Tracy McMillion. First of all, before we get into all the regalia, and you're looking pretty dapper there, you got a chance to sit off camera and hear the mayor say, of the city of Fort Myers, say some great things about you and the fire department. How did that make you feel to hear that?
You know, always humbled and honored to have words like that said about the department. You know, when it comes to myself, you know, I try to keep things low key. I just like the grind to grind, you know, so my drive is not, you know, the opinions of others. My grind is to do what's right for the city of Fort Myers. But I am super proud of the words that were said about the fire department, because that brings joy to my heart to know that our men and women that protect this city are thought of in a good light. So I just love it, and that's my job. My role is to support and serve them so they can continue to do that amazing job. So
we're sitting here at the Luminary Hotel, the centerpiece of downtown Fort Myers, and the mayor talked sterlingly about the importance of this hotel here and the great work that the great benefit is to the River District. As a fireman, high rise, is our fire department fancy like New York, where we can deal with a fire in a high rise like a hotel like this?
Oh, absolutely. And this is one of these things, and I love this project. This is an amazing, you know, piece to the downtown corridor, sitting right off the river, being a, you know, autograph hotel. It is beautiful. But one of the things that we had was the opportunity to see this particular project from the start to where it is today, which is amazing. And with that being said, one of the things that we do pre-go walkthroughs. So while they're constructing the building, and we work well with the staff here, they allowed us to come in and actually do tours and see it. So we're able to see the internals of the structure. We're able to see once they got to this phase, okay, now we moved in this phase. And so as we're doing that, we're actually creating our strategies, our tactics, to be able to mitigate any type of emergency that would have you know, in this particular structure. They are up to code, our fire prevention
works. Got all the sprinklers and everything.
So, and that's one of the things that this building is engineered for safety. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the things that we appreciate with the fire codes, and we appreciate with our developers and the owners and occupants of this particular hotel, because they're always so great to work with.
Okay.
There's never an issue or problem.
Man, so they need that. Yeah, that was a great public relations comment there. Yeah. I just thought I'd roll into that. Yeah. We're downtown city of Fort Myers, and you are the chief. What is the state of the city of Fort Myers Fire Department?
Wow, city of Fort Myers Fire Department is in a great place. I would probably say the word amazing, but I'm trying to keep it low, you know, but we are in a great place. We actually have had some great support from the mayor, as you heard, but all the city council, the city manager, city staff, we are able to actually, and we love the citizens for this, to be able to support us in actually increasing and updating the fire assessment fee. And that's allowed us to actually to bring on more staff, bring on more apparatus, things we talk about, you know, being able to protect a structure like this, to be able to grow with the times. And we are in just a great state. Morale is high. Folks are out there. If folks are looking at our Facebook page or our Instagram page, you're seeing how active our firefighters are, not only, you know, taking care of safety, but also being in the community and working with folks and being with folks.
That is refreshing for us, because we have never seen our fire department community oriented in the past. That's a whole new dynamic. And that's something that you are really proactive in, and making sure that the fire department is involved in the community.
Absolutely.
Speak to why there's such passion for you.
I mean, this is just one of the things that's the core and the foundation of what the fire service is. Many people that come from different areas within our nation, they understand, they remember that, you know, community fire station, they see the doors rolled up, the Dalmatian, all that stuff that you see in photos and movies. And one of the things that's really innate about the fire service is that we are community oriented. We are community focused. And one of the things that we like to do is actually try to get out there, goes with our purpose statement, trying to prevent harm, trying to save property, trying to promote excellence. And part of doing that is actually being within the community, spending time with individuals, teaching them a little safety tip, teaching them how to keep their homes safe, teaching them how to actually drive on the road safely, as well as building relationships. And that is the biggest part, is just having those relationships before there is an emergency.
And your efforts around Community Connect, We're going to take a look at a public service announcement that airs on this show as it relates to Community Connect, and then we'll talk to you on the other side. Let's take a look.
Hello, my name is Tracy McMillion. I'm the fire chief of the City of Fort Myers Fire Department. And one of the things I'd like to actually just bring to your attention is a new technology that we have out in our fire department. It's called Community Connect. What we're trying to do is connect with you, our community. With this particular software, we have the opportunity to be able to know who lives in your residence, what type of dogs or animals who you have inside your home, so God forbid there's an emergency, we know what we're looking for. So if we know that you have a wife and two kids, we know, hey look, where's mom, where's dad, where's the two kids? And if you have a little pet, we know to look for your pet as well. Community Connect is a great technology for us as a fire department for emergencies to be able to connect with you all and give you much better service. Please sign up for Community Connect. We're your local fire department and we care dearly about you.
Now, in Community Connect that we just looked at, one of the things that you talked about is actually seems like a whole lot of planning in advance opportunity for residents and businesses to put certain things in place. So you guys would basically have a cheat sheet on what's going on at that particular house. Expound on it, if you will.
Yeah, so I mean, if you were to take the analogy, it's just like, you know, as they tell you, when you go to the grocery store, have a list. And this really is our grocery store list when it comes to public safety. When our community is able to, or our businesses are able to put information into Community Connect, and we can use this technology to give us a list of the things that we need to take care of if there's an emergency in that particular residence or that particular business. So it gives us kind of like a cheat sheet. It gives us, you know, heads up that, hey, grandma is on the third bedroom to the right. It gives us heads up to know that they have a dog named Fluffy that typically, you know, spends time underneath the sofa. So this way, when we go into those dark, you know, terrible times with fire and smoke and things like that, we know we can find the sofa really quickly and hopefully get out that family, that pet, that furry friend, you know, or be able to go, you know, down the hall where grandma might be. So it just gives us the roadmap to know how to actually mitigate situations so much better. And we're all about efficiency and effectiveness. And that really speaks to those two terms.
And if you spend time on your website and people seeing pictures that have been flashing, is that we see that the City of Fort Myers Fire Department is gradually but progressively starting to reflect the diversity of the city, yes, of the nation. Yes. You see all races, more recruits coming in. I think you said that the diversity in your recruitment process this time has been like something you've never seen in the history of the City of Fort Myers?
Yeah, I mean, I was really surprised. You know, I've been in the business 25 years, definitely worked on the hiring side, recruitment side for probably about 10 to 15 years of those 25 years. And to be able to have a posting, we had 225 applications and see the amount of diversity, Lee, I was speechless. I was blown away. I was like, wow, the amount of folks that were willing and wanting to work in our city to represent the City of Fort Myers of all shades and colors and genders and backgrounds. And it was pretty humbling, and I love it. And that's what we want to do. We want to reflect who we are. We capture that in our strategic plan for the fire department, as well as it's something special to see that little girl who's, you know, sitting on, you know, Price Street or MLK, to see an African-American female get out the back of the fire truck to go take care of an emergency. That's encouraging. Or to see that person who may be of, you know, Eastern descent, to see someone who looks like them doing the job. And it helps us there again to build relationships. It helps us to build relationships internally also, because when we sit at that dinner table and we talk life, people from different backgrounds and different, you know, upbringings and different things like that bring things to the table, and we grow as a fire department. Mm-hmm. So when we interact with different people that come from different backgrounds, we're better served, even if that person doesn't look exactly like them.
Right, and I'm gonna tie a lot of that together, because I noticed over the last year or so, a part of your community outreach where you see the firefighters out amongst the people participating in community events and so on and so forth, and there's always it's always difficult to recruit. Employment is always something, recruiting, competing with other cities, and so on and so forth. So to have another population, more people to come into career opportunities seeking with our fire department, do you think that it's tied that community outreach that you guys have been doing, the way you've gone about that as a fire department, contributes to people being comfortable and interested in that as a field of employment?
Absolutely. I think most people that get into the realm of public safety, or especially the fire department, they're looking for what we call a family. And oftentimes the fire department describes ourselves as a family. And we have really laid the foundation to really be seen internally and externally as a family. So when we go out into the community and we spend time with each other, we're being a family with our community, but internally we're also being a family. So I think a lot of what we've done with social media, a lot of what we've done of going to the different schools, actively recruiting and sharing our stories, our backgrounds openly with the public, has actually opened up doors for mm-hmm. others to say, you know what, that's a great job. I think I might want to try that or get into that. And then creating roles of mentorship. And that's one of the things that we do. We work well with our high schools that have fire programs. And one of the things I always say is that whether you want to become a firefighter or not, the things you can learn in a fire academy will shape you in anything you would ever want to do, because we challenge you, you know, emotionally, physically, sometimes for some even spiritually. So we challenge you, and that helps to give you the courage and the confidence to take on any type of situation that may come your way.
Mm-hmm. The early on, you talked about growth of the city.
Yes.
Like when our city is growing, we as citizens, we don't think about our fire department needs to be growing to compensate for the growth of the city. Yeah. Territorially, how are we positioned right now in terms of getting to locations in a certain amount of time that you guys keep up with?
Yeah, so one of the things that's really different about the city of Fort Myers, you know, we're 50 square miles, 49 square miles, you know, highways, you know, and we have diversity of landscape with waterways and all these other things. But we are expanding, we're growing. This beautiful hotel, this is a part of that growth, and we love it. But we have to, as a fire department, understand the growth and realize we have to change structurally, we have to change strategically, we have to change in so many different ways to be able to mitigate and take care of that growth. It's just like in your, you know, analogy, if you're a family, you know, and you have two additional kids, now you may have to go to the store and get a bigger vehicle. Mm-hmm. Now you may have to actually do different ways for your housing. So we as a fire department have done that structurally. We've looked at different ways. We've actually split the city in half, and now we have two battalion chiefs, where we used to historically only have one. But we realized the density of traffic, we realized the amount of population, it required that. So we're making changes, and that's why I love our city manager and leadership for giving us the funding and the direction and the support of our community to be able to make this happen. So we're able to be able to take care of all this growth and change.
Do we have physical substations or more stations that have been built? I think when I had you here about a year ago, it was some conversation about opening up some new stations. Had that come to pass?
Yes, sir. So we're still in the building process of that. So we currently have six stations, you know, put out strategically throughout the city. We have our seventh station being built on a 6 Mile Parkway, close to where the Heritage Palms community is, and that's going to take care of that south end of the city. We also did something very innovative. We actually purchased a residential home. And we're working right now with Lee County to get it through the land development order. But that's going to be a micro station.
Right.
A little small station that we're going to be able to respond to a particular enclave of the city that we were not able to respond to before.
That sounds very creative.
Yeah, and that's what we're doing. You know, we took a page out of some other fire departments, past that they've mm-hmm. done. Cape Coral did that. They, you know, purchased a house, I think it's off of Gator Lane, Station 10. And we spent time with them to learn, hey, how did you do that? And so that's what we use, that innovation in our city, thinking outside the box to be able to meet the needs of what we have going on.
Before I let you go, we talked sterlingly about the high amount of people who are applying for jobs there. Is it still fair to say that if somebody is listening right now and they're interested in career opportunities with the city of Fort Myers Fire Department, there's opportunities there, whether it be on the front line or in other administrative positions?
Yeah, we're always, you know, hiring. We have opportunities as, you know, attrition hits and people retire, different things pop up. And there's so many jobs outside of just being a firefighter within right. the fire department that people don't know about, like fire prevention, being a fire inspector. We have one job posting that will be closing soon that's for a logistics or a quartermaster who will do a lot of things internally. So there's so many different, you know, pieces of this cog to make the fire department run that we know we have to have good folks, good quality, good character to fit those particular jobs.
Well, Chief, congratulations on all the success. We're looking forward to getting you back to keep us up to date.
Yes, sir.
On the city of Fort Myers and what's happening with the fire department.
Yes, sir.
Let me bump you out. As the saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like the city of Fort Myers Fire Department and our fine chief, Tracy McMillion. And also, remember, Miami has the oranges, but Fort Myers got the
juice.
Got the juice. We'll be right back.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime. And also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.